For generations, we dreamed about a place to live and work in space. A place where life up there would benefit life down here. Today, that dream has come true. Research on the International Space Station improves lives all over the world. The station's benefits for humanity grow every day, and they can be told by the lives that have been changed.
Minas Gerais is a large state. Our territory is about the size of France, and we consist of 853 units and municipalities. There are large distances between our communities and many very isolated rural communities. We are using new technology that impacts the quality of prenatal care and the diagnostic capacity of the primary care doctor in these situations involving distant, isolated communities.
Providing medical care for people in remote locations, like distant rural communities or the International Space Station, can be difficult because trained medical personnel are not always available. NASA research teams develop techniques that enable astronauts aboard the space station with minimal training to operate an ultrasound device using simple printed guides. The ultrasound images are transmitted in real time to a doctor back on Earth, who can make medical decisions without actually being aboard the station. These same techniques have been adapted for use with portable ultrasound devices in communities where expert medical care is not always available.
My name is Joaquim Diniz. I'm a doctor in the town of Manga. In Manga, people live with a particularity, and that is isolation. We have a geographical barrier, that is the São Francisco River, which is both a blessing for the region, but it also isolates us. We live in a region where financial resources are few. People do not have a lot of work, but they are honest, good people who do not have much opportunity. So there are many needy people who need these resources and rely only on this institution to provide assistance. This is a technology that helps us solve many problems. That was the case of a patient who came to the hospital with severe respiratory failure, and the people realized she would die in just 20 to 30 minutes. We ran, we talked with Dr. Parzelli, who was training us to use the ultrasound. He came and applied the ultrasound and discovered large amounts of fluid around her lungs and heart. We performed a procedure and drained a lot of fluids. In 20 minutes, 10 minutes, the woman immediately experienced an improvement and in half an hour was already walking. It was like a miracle. Arise and walk. She was dying in front of us without people knowing what was happening. This ultrasound was instrumental in saving the life of that patient.